Summer Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here. Today I want to look at Universe Sandbox 2. So, let's get started with the lesson. Okay, wonderful people, this is a tutorial on using Universe Sandbox 2. So, first off, I'm going to go over here to settings, and we're going to look at some of the options and settings that we can actually do here. By the way, we always start with the solar system, where we see Sun, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, and Pluto way out there, as well as the asteroids. It's a wonderful simulation. Let's go in and let's look at the settings real fast. Notice on the general settings for the simulation, some things I like most would be the dynamic viewpoint, dynamic camera. That's there. For graphics, we can go full screen or not. We can change your resolutions. So other settings here, such as the glows, which really we'll see here in a moment there. See, especially the glow around the sun or other hot objects. Audio, you can have that on or off. You can also change the volume. And for the music, you can actually choose your own music if you didn't like this really restful, relaxing music, but I kind of like the music, so I'm going to leave it running there. And then for the input, now this is kind of important. A lot of times you want to do something, and here's all the shortcuts that you can see here. And one of the ones I like a lot there is the land one. You can land your camera onto the object you're looking at there. That's the letter C. Next is performance. And here, this allows you to really view everything, do crashes, do whatever you want, without really messing up your what you see on your screen. And so this really is a good option there for the performance. And then we have photo, so you can take photos, take snapshots, screenshots, all that, and change your sizes of your screenshots. You can do video capturing and all that. And the last one is debug. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's actually start using this. This taskbar down at the bottom of our screen, first off, you'll see a timer with a date. And notice I can increase the time, and the more that I press it over here to the right, the faster and faster it is. And then if I go over to the left, the slower and slower it is. And then down here, I can do a lot of different things too, such as I can click on add. Now down on my taskbar, I have edit, add. Let's go ahead and I'm going to click on add right now. We can add stars, planets, moons, minor planets, objects, galaxies, even black holes, and other special objects here. So let's go ahead and we're going to click on Earth. And right away, you notice as you move your mouse within the solar system, basically it's going to give you a orbital velocity around the main star of whatever you're working with. So in this case, it's the Sun. So let's put a second Earth right here. There we go. And if you right click, that unselects anything there. Now we can click on that second Earth. Notice when you do, you get this little menu here. You can get more information about it. There's the Earth mass and the size and also other things such as its density. And the temperature is falling fast. So let's click this up here. And now we can get more of the specifics. As you see, the temperature is of course falling because it's beyond the orbit of Mars there. What we're going to do is we'll click on some of these things here. But first, let's just look at all the different parameters you can have for your planet. You can increase its mass. So if I said it was 1.09 Earths, there we go. You notice that it's increased in size. The gravity is a little bit more now. And now we can go, let's say if we want to go to motion, this is orbital motion as well as other types of rotational motion there. Let's increase the speed here. So right now it's about, it has a day of 24 hours. Let's bring it down to 22 hours. There we go. So speeding a little bit faster. And if I click here on the Earth and then I scroll in, I can look around it. So let's slow its spin a little bit there. As you see, the continents are already frozen over. Pretty soon the whole oceans will be frozen too, unless I change something. So here's the temperature. As you see, it's falling quickly. And what we're going to do is let's increase this atmospheric pressure. You can change it. So let's go to atmospheres. Right now it's one atmosphere and dropping there. And let's increase that to 50 atmospheres. There we go. That's a lot denser atmosphere. And then we're going to go down and increase our carbon dioxide. We're going to add 100 times the amount of carbon dioxide there. And the temperature there is still falling slowly. So Earth is just too far from the sun to keep warm, even with a thick blanket of an atmosphere and a lot more carbon dioxide in its atmosphere there. So if we go down here, we can also see other properties of our atmosphere. And that's on the advanced settings. The greenhouse gases are here. If I go to materials, I can change the core, make more iron here. So if I want to increase the iron, there we go. And so I made my iron core a little bit larger there. That was kind of interesting. So here we can see the density has gone up since I increased the amount of iron is in this core. Let's see, actions. So I can save this object. I can do other things with this object too. That's pretty neat. So I can close that off. And I can zoom out here. And there's our new Earth. There's our old Earth there, and there's our new Earth. Let's increase the time there and see if it disrupts the orbits of Mars or any of the other planets there. Let's increase it a lot. Excuse me, let me focus here on the sun. And let's increase it there. So we're increasing time. Looks like we have a pretty stable solar system, even when we drop Earth there between the orbits of Jupiter and Mars. That's pretty amazing. Even with all the asteroids there, it hasn't changed much of anything. Okay, so that's a little quick introduction to it. Let's do something else here. Notice that I could, if I wanted to, drop in a star. So if you just grab something like Betelgeuse here, this is the size of Betelgeuse in relation to our solar system. It's just massive. If you right click, there you go, that goes away. Okay, other types of objects. If I click on objects here, we can put in all these little objects here into the simulation. So things like pumpkins or New Horizons or even the third stage of a Saturn V, the Great Pyramid of Giza. So there's a lot of little things that you can fling around in this simulation. And don't forget, you can also put galaxies and black holes. Let's say you want to make a new solar system. You just click on Home and then click on New. There we are. Now we got a tabula rasa. We got it all blank slate. Let's go click on Add Object. Let's see what kind of object we have. Maybe we want a black hole. So let's click on a black hole that's about 100 suns. And drop it right there. Right click, that unselects it there. And let's see what would happen if I have a planet Earth. There we go. Orbiting a black hole. Let's see. Let's put it right there. Wow. It's moving pretty fast. Let's speed up time a little bit here. And now let's go ahead and let's put in the sun. So we'll click on the sun here and let's put the sun right there. There it is. Now we have the sun and the earth orbiting a black hole. That's something that you don't want to see every day, right? So let's click on the earth here. And let's get more information about the climate. As you can see here, it's the sun is orbiting a black hole, so the light's going to be variable. So the temperature is going to vary quite a lot here. And looks like we have a pretty stable system. Pretty nice. We put in a red dwarf also into the system. So we click here, let's put it way out here. Okay. Now if I increase the time, there we go, we can see our little system going and the temperature is rising on our little planet because the Earth is kind of close to the sun. There's the temperature rising there. I increase it a little bit more. Oh yeah. Talk about global warming. Now the nice thing is we can change the speed of it here. Let's change the speed. And I can click on the sun. Change the speed a little bit more. There we go. Just click on that sun. And let's change the mass of the sun. And make it into something akin to maybe a yellow dwarf or orange dwarf there. So instead of being one mass of the sun, let's go with 0.3. Okay, whoa, that changed it a lot. Now let's click back on our Earth climate. We got pretty hot there. And let's increase the time. There, now you see the temperature is dropping. Let's increase the time some more. Now what I can do is I can go click here and if I click C, there we are, now we've landed on the Earth. We can look around. I'm going to get really dizzy here in a minute. And there's the sun and the black hole. Okay, I'm going to jump off Earth here and leave it there. Let's see, what other things can we do? Let's see, I know people like things to crash into things, so we can actually do that. Let's say that, let's decrease the time here. Notice I can click on the Earth, go to motion, and this is the speed of it right now. If I change the speed to something like 2 kilometers per second, it's going to start falling into the black hole. And let's speed up time a little bit. Bye-bye, Earth. You're going to fall into the black hole and shoom, there you go. Ooh, the Earth has been turned into rubble. Look at that. Oh my goodness. There's nothing left of the Earth. Okay, wonderful people. Let's create a new simulation. So let's go and click on add and let's add a Jupiter. And if we add another Jupiter, not too close. That's pretty close still. And one question comes up is how many Jupiter masses would it take to create a brown dwarf for it to actually be a little star? So let's go over here to change its mass to Jupiter's. And if I increase its mass to, let's say something like 73, boom. That's, whoa, look at that. That's pretty cool. It's still not glowing there as a star. But if we keep on dropping Jupiters into it, so let's add a few Jupiters here. And on these Jupiters, let's decrease their motion. So that's, ooh, things are colliding. There we go. That one is starting to fall in. Boom, ooh, that one crashed in. So we're at 75 Jupiters, yet we still do not have a star. Let's go to this Jupiter, and let's decrease its motion to 5 there. And it's starting to fall in. This has been increasing in temperature through the tidal forces on this one. So let's go into this Jupiter, and let's decrease its momentum there tremendously. So it's going to fall. Let's decrease the momentum of this one too. And see what happens. So now we have these Jupiters that are falling into the main Jupiter here. This main Jupiter, let's watch its mass here. Its mass is at 75. Let's see what happens. Ooh, look at that. Oh, it lost a lot of mass in that collision, unfortunately. But it's red hot from the collision. Try this again. Let's go new. Let's go add Jupiter. And this time we won't be colliding anything with it. We'll just keep on increasing its mass. So Jupiter's here, so let's go 76 Jupiters. Wow. And then let's go 77 Jupiters. Okay. 80 Jupiters. Oh, there we go. 80 Jupiters. And it's a brown dwarf. I shouldn't say red dwarf. That's a brown dwarf. It's really low on the mass scale. So if we put something like a Earth, and if the Earth was orbiting this low mass star, let's see, let's go out to here. Let's see what's happening on the Earth. Let's click on the Earth and we can go to the climate. And if I increase the time there, so I'm increasing movement of time. And you notice there, we would basically be frozen. There's very little heat coming off of this brown dwarf. So how close would we have to move the Earth in to actually survive? So we can't survive there. It would be just too cold, right? So what we're going to do here is, let's go in and let's change the speed there. Let's click on actions and let's delete this object entirely. And let's fly into Jupiter here. Let's grab an Earth and this time let's put it right there. Whoa. That seems pretty close. When you're really close to an object like this, you'd be tidally locked. That means one side of the Earth would be facing this this object all the time. Okay, I'm going to focus on the Earth here. And even though it's this close to this brown dwarf, let's see how cold it is. Climate. It's pretty cold. Yeah, so that's, wow, it's just above freezing. Are you kidding me? And it's that close. Okay, so it's the year on the Earth would be only 10 days. So we're so close to the brown dwarf here that a whole year is only 10 days. We would be tidally locked to this little star. So yeah, it's not a happy place, to be for the Earth. So let's go new. Let's create a little solar system here. So let's have a sun. And let's go away from the sun. And let's have an Earth. Let's collide the Earth with something. So let's go out here and let's focus on the Earth. Here we go. And now let's launch. Let's get a nice view of the Earth. There it is. Let's launch a Mars-size object right into the Earth. Let's see what happens. Ready? Let's hit and aim for here. There we go. Woo, let's slow down time here. Oh, yes. Oh, bye-bye, Earth. A lot of major fragments. Another moon would probably be created. Look at all the objects just flying everywhere here. If we click on the Earth mass here, it says lost mass. So a lot of mass was flown away and it's gathering it back. Let's look at the climate. Oh dear, there is no life whatsoever anywhere on the Earth. Ay, 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 that is a high temperature. That's okay, we're back to one Earth mass as things keep on falling into it. Wow, something as big as the moon just collided with the Earth and created there, because the Earth and moon there, the moon is 1% the mass of the Earth. And look at these other objects. They're about to collide too. Let's see. Boom. Okay. Wow. And now let's go with the climate. The temperature is really high. Let's look at the atmosphere. Do we have an atmosphere even left here? Let's see. Atmosphere mass. Let's see, compared to surface pressure. So let's go. It would be one. Oh my goodness. We do not have an atmosphere. That should be one. So now we're down to 1/3. Or, you know, just about 0.3 of the atmosphere of what we used to have. Let's launch Mercury now into this planet. There we go. Ooh, that is amazing. That is really amazing. Look at motion here. Oh my goodness. Our day is now only 4.5 hours long. Look at that rotational period, guys. And let's go to basic here. The mass of the Earth has increased a little bit. And we have a huge number of fragments going around the Earth. Oh, here comes a large object right now. Shoom. Oh, yeah. That is neat. Okay, now let's go ahead and let's now click on open. And let's go to the solar system. Let's just click on the general solar system here. Here we are. So let's start a new blank solar system here. And oh, look, you got your planets there. That's nice. Let's click on the Earth. And let's click on its climate, 15 degrees, almost 16 degrees centigrade. That's a nice warm place there. And what would happen if I had the Earth orbiting the Earth? So let's slow down the simulation. Let's fall into the Earth, not the Sun. So there it is. Let's fall in. And let's slow down time a little bit. And let's go add the Earth. See, how do I want this? Hmm. Let's add it right there. Okay. And let's click on that Earth right now. Look at the basics. And let's go down to the orbital elements. They're orbiting each other, by the way. And let's see how many days it takes to orbit each other. So it takes two. Oh, we've had problems. Take about 2 days to orbit each other. And I think through tidal forces, we are ripping the planets apart. Let's look at the climate. Yeah, the temperature is rising here because the Earth is being squeezed. The gravitational forces is causing them to squeeze towards each other, and it's causing major earthquakes and other havoc. And look at the temperature. Pretty soon the water would be boiling away there if it keeps on doing that. Let's look and see what it looks like from a distance. So that's what you'd get if you try to orbit two. Oh, look at that. They got really close. Look at that. Oh my goodness. You just killed all the Earth life. Oh my goodness. Let's see what other things that we can do here. Let's make a new empty solar system here, a new empty space. And then add all the planets. So there's a Mercury. What would happen if I add, let's pause time here for us. Let's add a Venus. Next, let's add an Earth. Let's add a Mars. Let's add, Jupiter's big. Let's add Jupiter here. Let's change our perspective a little bit. Where's the light coming from? Let's add a Saturn here. Okay. And then let's add the rest here. There's Uranus, Neptune. Okay, let's add a little Pluto here. And now let's start the simulation. Oh, yes. Boom. Whoa. You got a very hot Jupiter after a while. A lot of huge fragments. And let's see, Jupiter, let's see how many Jupiter masses it is. It's actually lost mass in all this, so a lot of mass was flung out, but it's falling in, some of it's falling in, and some of it is just being lost there. Okay, let's make another simulation here. So let's go new, and let's add a Jupiter, but this time let's make this Jupiter, let's make it a lot larger. Let's go with 78 times the mass there. So basically it's almost a brown dwarf. And then let's orbit here a number of objects. Okay, so we have a Jupiter surrounded by all of these Venuses, and I've slowed them down so they don't have very much momentum. And let's see what happens when we turn on time. There they are, they're moving. Look at the beautiful pattern. Ooh, they're colliding there. Ooh, this one's about to crash into Jupiter. Another one. Ooh, they're all falling in. Let's see what happens. Whoa. The mass is increasing.
Oh,
Jupiter's getting hot. Okay, it's time to launch something big at Jupiter. So let's launch a Saturn to Jupiter and see what happens. Let's go, let's hit it right here. Whoa. Okay, Jupiter is increasing in size a little bit, but still not enough to become a brown dwarf or anything. So let's launch. That's when we launch a Jupiter into Jupiter. Woo, there we go! We got light. 79.3 Jupiter mass. Now, let's start a new simulation. Let's add something here. Let's go ahead and let's add a Jupiter mass here. And now let's launch some things into it. Let's get something more massive out here. A Phobos. Now Phobos is one of the moons of Mars. And let's hit Jupiter with that. Oh yeah. Okay. Okay. Oh, there we go. I'm starting to see. Ooh, look at the effects there. Yeah. We gave Jupiter a black eye, everyone. Let's increase the time here. There it is. Let's now launch a. These are large objects. Here we go. Let's go Mimas. Okay. Whoa, there we go. Let's do Mimas again here. Yeah. Let's do the moon. Ooh. Look at the fireball that's being made. These are growing really fast. 10% the speed of light? Yeah. Let's go 1% the speed of light here. And launch it. Okay, let's now launch something bigger. Let's launch a Venus, which is almost the size of the Earth. Let's launch a Earth. The mass of Mars is 1/10 that of the Earth. Let's launch that. Wow. We're actually pushing Jupiter away from us. Let's see. Let's do this. A Jupiter with a Saturn. Look at that. And that's a lot of force. Okay. Lots of Earths. What if I was to do a Jupiter into this? What would happen? Oh yeah, there you go. Jupiter is, oddly enough, it's lost a lot of mass. And you have all these fragments. Look at that, you have another Jupiter here. And you even have a Saturn out here. Wow. Wow, that is amazing. So now let's go in and let's see here. Let's. What if we just. Okay. Another Jupiter. Jupiter, 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 Jupiter. Jupiter, Jupiter. Jupiter. Just. I'm just making a lot of Jupiters here and seeing what happens. What's the limit of this thing? Look at this. Wow. That's crazy. What a ride, huh? Let's get back to our chaos here. Okay, so what if we start with a red dwarf? There you go. Two red dwarfs. And let's orbit that one. Whoa! That was exciting. That was exciting. Okay, it looks like these two are going to collide. You got, wow. There it goes. Whoa! Oh, yoy yoy. We've just destroyed a system. If I increase it in the time there, look at all the, look, we made a this is the nebula, everyone. We've made a nebula. Wow, with all these objects flying away from it. That is so cool. We can look at it, and that's what a nebula looks like. Oh my goodness. Things are still crashing into each other. There we go. Oh, yay, yay. Look at the mass drop. Drop down to only 7 Jupiter masses after all that. Let's see what this one is. It's a little bit more massive than Jupiter. I drop a sun into this. Let's see what happens to the sun. Ooh. Whoa. Oh, shoo. Supernova. Oh my gosh. This is how you make a supernova. Look at the beautiful clouds. So I drop another sun here. Okay, so there's one sun with one solar mass. And if I drop another sun to it, there we go. About triple. Wow. And that's orbit. Let's cause some havoc. Let's see. There we go. And now let's increase time and see what happens. Ooh, supernova. That's when two suns collided, by the way. Okay, this sun right here still has one solar mass. And if I get an Earth and I orbit the Earth 1 AU from it, there we go. What would the temperature be on this Earth? Okay, I think the Earth just vaporized. Let's try this again. Okay, there we go. It's vaporizing. Wow. So a planet cannot exist in this environment. It just gets shredded. Let's see, well, if I put something more substantial, such as Saturn. Okay. Saturn is losing mass. Yep, it's losing mass right now. So it's being pulled apart. And the temperature is, look how hot it is. This is a very hot environment right now. So anything that you'd put in there basically just evaporates away. It just melts away, and it's so hot that the gases escape its vicinity, and it loses its mass. So you can actually see the gases coming off. Look at that. You can actually see the gases. So it's losing a lot of mass. Wow. The suns are stable. Let's see this one. This one's losing mass too. And then this Jupiter. Oh, this Jupiter's far enough away from everything. It's stable. And this one now here, it's not losing any more mass. That's good. But this low Saturn. Oh, look how hot it is. It's just losing all of its mass to space. Okay. And that's the supernova remnant behind us there. Okay, well, if I put, go far out here. Okay, I'm going to put a sun 1 light year away from the supernova. Okay. And then, let me focus on that sun. Wow, look how beautiful that is. A supernova from 1 light year away. You won't want to be there because you would be cooked. Let's focus in on the sun here. And let's put the Earth right there. And so let's see what happens to the Earth. Ah, it's starting to warm up from the effects of this supernova that's just a year away. So let's watch the supernova over time. And look at that, it'll actually expand out to us. Even a light year away. It's not too hot on the Earth, but we'd be receiving a large amount of radiation from the supernova. And if the Earth was, in fact, just 1 light year away, I'm not sure we'd actually be doing so well. That's a beautiful sight, eh? It just fills the sky. Look at that. We'd be basically engulfed. Look at that. There's the sun and the Earth system. We'd basically be engulfed, guys, in this supernova remnant. There in just so many years. Oh, look at that. Okay, there are some weird things happening to the Earth's temperature. Look at that. It's freezing. Getting really hot and then freezing, getting hot, freezing, getting hot. Something has happened. Something has really gone off. Let's look at the motion here. So apparently something went pretty... Ooh, 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 ooh. something went really close to the Earth and caused it to. Let's see. Let me focus on the Earth here a little bit. Let me slow down time. And let's focus here. Okay, we're pretty hot now. And there's the motion. Now we're cooling off. We're freezing. Hot and cold. We're in a really bad orbit. Wow. So there you go. There's your supernova. And that is beautiful. To see that would be very scary, to see that in the night sky glowing like that, and it being that close. Wow, the Universe Sandbox 2 is a lot of fun. It's a great program. If you're watching this on YouTube, please give this video a thumbs up, share, and comment down below, because I love to read your comments. Also, if you have other ideas of other situations that you want to see in the Universe Sandbox 2, let me know in the comments, and I'll make videos of those as well. Thank you again, and bye-bye.